What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to Smart Tech. Today we're going to be talking about an interesting brand new router. Now, this particular version of the router known as the Linksys WRT series is known for one particular thing. It's really, really good for the average consumer, but at the same time, it's usually packed with behind the scenes features that allows it to be really, really awesome for people who maybe run a small business or are just a little bit more tech savvy and want to tweak their routers just the way they like. Now, of course, this particular version, known as the WRT3200 ACM series, comes with a bunch of brand new features as well, but the top four are of course the fact that it has a dual core 1.8 gigahertz CPU built directly into it. It also has 512 megabytes of RAM. Now, of course, these two, you're like, why exactly would a router need this? Well, it makes it a lot more convenient when it comes to handling multiple processes, multiple devices, and of course, if you tweak your router and add a few additional settings, then it does take the CPU's power and it is relevant. Now, of course, according to this, this is a Tri-Stream 160 with 2x the bandwidth, which makes it the fastest 5 gigahertz band on any router out there, which is absolutely insane. This router also comes included with an application which basically makes it so you can access it over the cloud, and of course you can remotely access your router from wherever you please and tweak settings and mess around with maybe certain files on your NAS or media drive if you actually have one. Then of course you can have 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz simultaneously. That's default for routers these days. It also has something called beamforming, and this basically focuses the signal to your device, and basically that makes it so the performance and of course the signal is the best. Also, I don't know if you guys can see this, but it has 4 giant antennas, so you can actually position the antennas based on where the floors are in your house, and of course, to give the best possible connection and best possible speed to every single spot inside of your house or your office or wherever you'll be placing this. It does have a USB 3.0 port. It also has an eSATA port, which is also more or less default for high-end routers these days, but it also has gigabit Ethernet ports, and these gigabit Ethernet ports are 10 times faster than your typical fast Ethernet. There's also a WPA2 and of course encryption and an SPI firewall, which basically keeps everything super safe. And once again, if you tweak the settings, you can make things way more secure, especially with the lack of privacy and security these days. Finally, there is guest access. There's also parental controls, and I actually love Linksys parental controls. It makes it super convenient to maybe get rid of Wi-Fi at a certain amount of time for a certain person. Say you have kids and you don't want them accessing the internet at, you know, 1 a.m. at night, then of course you could go and mess with those settings and set it so only their internet goes down at that particular time. I know there's a lot of parents out there that just shut off the router, but of course with these features, it makes everything just a little bit more automated and convenient. So next off, I thought I'd get to the more tech savvy things and how this thing is engineered for perfect customization. First of all, everyone out there who are really tech savvy really like things that are open source ready. Well, this thing is customizable with OpenWRT and DDWRT right out of the box, and this makes it super flexible so you can customize things with the, when you're using it with, say, gaming, privacy, VoIP, and of course, small office applications. There's a dozen other uses for that as well, for example, VPNs. I know a lot of people are setting those up these days. So of course that makes it really awesome. Now, you guys may have questioned, what exactly does Tri-Stream 160 mean? Basically, it means that there are 3 160 megahertz at 867 megabytes a second going towards your, well, that's your connection speeds going outwards. So of course, a total connection speed of 2.6 gigabytes per second. That is absolutely insane. I mean, most people don't have internet that fast, of course, and don't need power like that. But if you actually have multiple devices, I don't know, some people's houses these days, or even offices, have dozens of devices connected, this is the device for you. Another thing that has to do with dozens of devices being connected is something called MU MIMO routers. So this basically means that Wi-Fi to multiple devices at once at the exact same speed. It's going to balance it out so every device gets the exact same powerful speed. And back in the day, you know, we'd have this issue where maybe the laptop would get like 100 megabytes per second if anyone had that speed, and then of course one device would get 50, another device would get like 20, and as more devices connected, the speed would get slower and slower. Well, with this new technology, hopefully that won't be the case. One last thing about the application, what exactly can you do with it? Well, you can actually easily control your Wi-Fi devices. It tells you who is connected at a particular moment. You can go ahead and give certain people guest access, and you can share your Wi-Fi via email or text and get notifications if you're So next off, I thought we'd go ahead and take a look around the router. The overall design is classic Linksys. We've all seen routers like this, but this time we get ourselves the awesome 4 massive antennas, and then on the back we get ourselves a Wi-Fi protected setup. Then of course, this little button basically makes it so you can easily connect your devices simply by pressing this. After that, there are gigabit Ethernet ports. There are 4 of those. There's the input for your internet cable that goes to your modem or whatever else. And then of course, there's the USB 3.0 right next to that. I also really like the spacing. I've seen a few routers where everything is sort of cramped together. That makes things super frustrating and makes cable management an absolute insane job to do properly. But of course, everything's spaced out here, so that's awesome. Right next to that, eSATA and USB 2.0 as well. It kind of doubles as that, which is really interesting. And finally, there's the reset button, of course the DC input, and a power switch for turning the router on and off. On the top, there are vents, and I will mention this, it gets a little warm, but overall, don't put anything on top of it. That's a bad idea, but it's not something that's going to overheat or anything of that sort, as far as I have tried in my testing. On the front, of course, we get ourselves the LED indicators, which is for power. There's one for internet. There's one for 2.4 gigahertz network, your 5 gigahertz network, and then there are 3 optional ones that basically represent your eSATA, your USB 1, and your USB 2, with finally a few other LEDs on the right side to say that each antenna is working, I believe. And finally, there is one last LED. So overall, that is about it for the overall design. I like it. It is a little big, but at the same time, it keeps everything super. It has a lot packed into it, and for that form factor, I'd say it is pretty well made. Finally, I thought I would go ahead and share my overall experience with this router. Setting it up was super, super simple. The application is a little bit clunky, but overall, it's super easy to get into, super easy to set up. I wouldn't say it's the most daily usage type of thing, but every once in a while you may just need to sign in. And if you guys have NAS or media devices connected to it, those are also pretty easy to set up. Parental controls, pretty easy to set up. And overall, if you are just looking for a router to basically go to multiple devices at once, you simply hook this up, put in the password or change the password of course, and then connect it to your devices, and you are all set to go. At most, it could take you 5 minutes. If you decide to mess around with the settings, it could take you a few hours. But overall, I assume that most people who are getting this router are simply getting it to connect things, and in that case, I estimate your average time to set this up would be 10 to 15 minutes. So overall, guys, I'd say I really like the setup process, which is one of the most tedious parts of having a router. As for whether this thing will last, I'd say it is built to last probably years and years and years, and it is future-proof as well due to all the features that are packed into it. It can support my 100 megabyte per second speeds, and it gives me 97 to 98 megabytes per second to my Wi-Fi devices, so that is pretty awesome. And if it is a wired connection, I'm usually getting 109 to 110, and of course 30 to 50 upload speeds as well, which is really, really awesome. Then finally, the last thing I want to say is a connection. So how good is the signal? Well, the 4 antennas make it so the signal goes everywhere. I'd say there are no dropout zones, and even if there are, you can tweak the antennas just slightly, and that should be able to solve any issues that you have with the router. Overall, I give it a nice solid 10 out of 10. This may be one of the best routers I have ever seen, and of course, one of the best routers of 2016 going into 2017. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If so, leave a like, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you guys for watching. This is going to be me logging off.